In this video, we are going to discuss RC coupled amplifier circuit. Okay, what do you mean by RC coupled amplifier circuit? From the name itself, we can say that this R indicates resistors, C indicate capacitors. So here we can see resistor capacitor combination. So RC coupled resistor capacitor combination with one NPN transistor makes an amplifier in this circuit. Here the transistor used is NPN transistor and the configuration used is common emitter configuration. That means emitter is common for input base and output collector. So here in this diagram we can see various parameters like VCC. VCC is the supply voltage. Here you can see R1, R2 resistors. This R1, R2 resistors forms the voltage divider network. This R1, R2, RE, it is mainly used for proper biasing and stabilization of this circuit. So first one is biasing. So the biasing is used here is voltage divider biasing. So why do we use this voltage divider biasing? First of all, what is the need of biasing? So we all know that biasing is a very important factor because biasing gives proper voltage to this NPN transistor to work properly. If the biasing is not correct, then there will be distortion. Here the biasing circuit is voltage divider biasing circuit because the stability of the voltage divider biasing is very high. That's why the reason behind the use of voltage divider biasing. So we can see the voltage divider network here, R1, R2, RE, three resistors that forms that mainly used for biasing and stabilization. So we are collecting output from this RC collector resistor. So we covered need of biasing, and here we can see we are used common emitter configuration. Why we use common emitter configuration means this configuration gives better results. This configuration gives good gain, good current gain and good voltage gain. That's why the reason behind the use of common emitter configuration. So the configuration used is common emitter configuration. Then in this circuit diagram we can see two coupling capacities. This is the first coupling capacitor or this is the input coupling capacitor CC. So this capacitor is called coupling capacitor or blocking capacitor. So why the name coupling? This capacitor is used to couple the input voltage to this circuit or to the base of this NPN transistor, and also it blocks the presence of DC. It only allows AC input signal to the base terminal. So likewise, here also we have a coupling capacitor. This is also a coupling and blocking capacitor. This coupling capacitor couples the output from this collector to the output, or we can couple the output of this first amplifier to the input of the second amplifier. Thereby we can make a two-stage amplifier. Okay, so this is coupling capacitor 1 and this is coupling capacitor 2. Then here we can see another capacitor. This is called bypass capacitor. Bypass. So why the name bypass capacitor? So this bypass capacitor is used to bypass the amplified signal present at this emitter terminal. If this capacitor is not present here, then some voltage will be developed across this resistor and this voltage makes some negative feedback, and that negative feedback will reduce the strength of the input signal. Thereby there will be a chance of AC degeneration. So the signal developed at this point will be bypassed through this capacitor. That is use of bypass capacitor. Here we can see input voltage is Vin. This voltage is very very small, approximately apply 100 millivolt as the input signal, and we are collecting the amplified output at the collector. Let's see the working of this amplifier. So what is the working behind it? As I said, the common emitter configuration is used here. As we know, in common emitter configuration, the gain is beta and it is equal to IC by IB. That is collector current divided by base current, or output current divided by base current. So from this equation we can say the output current, it is equal to beta into input current. So the input current is IB because of this voltage Vin. So if a small signal applied at this base generates the base current IB, and it is multiplied with a multiplication factor or gain beta, gives IC. So IC is the output current and it gives the amplified signal. Then I would like to explain the relation between input voltage and output voltage, or the graph between input voltage and output voltage. Okay. So let's say this is the input voltage. We can draw the output like this. So this input-output relationship shows that there is a 180 degree phase shift between the input and the output. So what is the reason behind it? 180 degree phase shift. In order to find out the reason behind this phase shift, we have to consider this outer loop of this RC coupled amplifier. So consider this outer loop and apply KVL in this circuit. So in this outer loop we can see the voltages are VCC, then the current through IC is, the current through RC is IC, and the voltage is IC into RC. Here also the current is IE and the voltage is IE into RE, and we can see a voltage VCE between collector and emitter. So consider this IE into RE, consider this IC into RC, consider VCE and also consider VCC. So by applying KVL we can write one equation like this, that is VCC minus VCE minus ICRC minus IERE is equal to 0. So in this case, let's say IC is equal to IE. If IC is approximately equal to IE, then we can write VCE is equal to VCC minus IC into RC plus RE. So VCE is equal to, we can get VCC minus IC into RC plus RE. So this is the major equation behind this explanation. Okay, from this equation we can say that this VCC is constant, this resistance values are also constant. So we can say that this VCE is directly proportional to minus IC into some resistance value. These resistance values are constant. So VCE and IC both are inversely proportional. This IC into R gives a voltage value. What is VCE? VCE is the output voltage. Then when the input voltage increases, let's say when the input voltage increases, the input current also increases. So from, we know that IC is equal to beta into IB. So when IB increases, from this equation we can say that IC also increases. When IC increases, according to this equation, VCE also increases, but in a negative direction, or it is inverted. That is the reason why we will get output signal, amplified signal with a 180 degree phase shift. So in this video, we have discussed the major components of RC coupled amplifier, the working of RC coupled amplifier. For that, use this equation. Then the relationship between input and output, the reason for 180 degree phase shift. For that, we need to consider this KVL equation and write this equation and also use this equation. So from this equation, we can say that the output voltage is in inverted format. Our next video is for frequency response of RC coupled amplifier. So this is the diagram for RC coupled amplifier. I have already explained this coupling capacitor is the blocking capacitor, and also the input voltage that should be very small, which is to be amplified. So I have taken one example. Input voltage is equal to 100 millivolt and we can apply some frequency. So consider input voltage is equal to 100 millivolt and apply some frequency which is equal to 100 hertz. Okay, if we do one experiment like this, if we apply input voltage like this, we can draw a table like this. So I have given F is equal to 100 hertz here. So let 100 hertz here. Input voltage is equal to 100 millivolt. Then calculate the output voltage. So calculate this output voltage here. Then calculate the gain in this column. Then change the frequency to 200 hertz. Input voltage is same. Calculate the output voltage and calculate the gain. So continue this experiment up to some megahertz value. You will get some gain value corresponding to frequency variations. So we need to plot this frequency versus gain in this logarithmic graph. Sorry, in this semi-log graph. So we can draw this frequency versus gain in normal graph sheet or semi-log graph sheet. So we will get a diagram like this. This is the frequency response of this RC coupled amplifier. Frequency response means response of voltage gain to the frequency variations, or the response of output voltage to this frequency variations. So gain is plotted in the y-axis, frequency plotted in the x-axis, and we can see three regions here. So this is the low frequency region, this is the medium frequency region, and this is the high frequency region. So the low frequency region is from 0 hertz to 50 hertz, and from 50 hertz to 20 kilohertz it is mid frequency region. Then above 20 kilohertz it is high frequency region. So from this graph we can see that during low frequency range the gain is less. During high frequency region gain is less. In mid frequency region gain is maximum and it is constant. Let's see the reason behind it. So we know that capacitive reactance is equal to 1 by 2 pi fc. Capacitive reactance, the reactance or the resistance offered by the coupling capacitor. So in low frequency region frequency should be small. When frequency is small, reactance should be high. When reactance is high, so we need to consider this coupling capacitor. When the reactance of this coupling capacitor is high, then a very small part of the signal will come to the base. or a very small part of the signal will come to this amplifier or come to this NPN configuration for amplification. For that reason, gain decreases. Let's consider high frequency cases. When frequency is high, reactance decreases. When frequency is high, reactance decreases, and at that time the coupling capacitor offers low reactance. That means more signal will come to this base. More signal will come from the input side for amplification. This more signal will cause high loading in this amplifier section. That is called loading effect, and due to this loading effect, the gain decreases. Then consider medium frequency range. So when we are increasing the frequency, above 50 Hz, when we are increasing the frequency, the reactance decreases. When reactance decreases, more signal will come from this input side to this amplifier. For that reason, if you are increasing frequency above 50 Hz, the gain increases. But at the same time, when we reach this 20 kilohertz, so this is high frequency range, when frequency is very very high, the reactance is very very small, at that time loading effect occurs and then gain decreases. So due to these two reasons, in mid frequency range gain is maximum and it is constant. So this is the explanation for frequency response of RC coupled amplifier. So gain, actually the equation for gain is equal to 20 log Vout divided by Vin. So next I would like to explain why this equation is taken for calculating gain. Okay, from this frequency response graph we need to calculate the bandwidth also. So for bandwidth calculation, so this is gain axis. Gain is a logarithmic unit and it is expressed in dB. So this is y axis is in dB. So we need to take 3 dB down, or we can say minus 3 dB from this maximum value. Then extend a line like this. So we will get a frequency here, that is FL, lower cutoff frequency, and from this point we will get another frequency point, that is upper cutoff frequency. So from this lower cutoff frequency and upper cutoff frequency, we can calculate bandwidth is equal to FH minus FL. Then there is again a question, why we have taken 3 dB? Why not 4 dB? Why not 2 dB? Why not 2.5 dB like that? For that, we need to consider gain equation. So actually, gain is a ratio. It is the ratio of output to input. Okay. In this diagram, we have taken this 3 dB down and we got a point here. If we extend a line from here to here, we got a line here. So this point is called 3 dB point. Or another name for this point is half power point. Or another name for this point is, at this point the voltage is, the output voltage is 70.7% of the maximum voltage or the input voltage. So we have a point here. First we have taken 3 dB. From 3 dB we have a point here. This is the 3 dB point. This is a half power point. And at this point, the output voltage is 70.7% of that input voltage. So what is half power point? Half power point means the point at which the output power is half of the input power. and the output voltage is 70.7% of the input voltage. So we can see a connection between power and voltage. This point represents both power and voltage. Let's say the equation for gain is equal to output divided by input. So I would like to say this gain is a logarithmic quantity. So I can express like this: log P out divided by P in bell. So gain is equal to output power divided by input power bell. So this term introduced by Alexander Graham Bell. So I would like to multiply it with 10. That is equal to log P out divided by P in decibel. So deci means 10. So P out divided by P in. So we know that power is directly proportional to V square. Okay. So by substituting this, we will get 10 log V out square divided by V in square. Okay. So it is also in decibel. So it is equal to 10 into log V out divided by V in the whole square dB, which is equal to 20 log V out divided by V in decibel. This is the equation I substituted here. So this is 20 log V out divided by V in. It is equal to gain. So we have a gain equation in voltage format and we have a gain equation in power format. Okay. So we need to connect this power and voltage. So from the half power point, we know that the output power is half of the input power. Okay, so instead of output power, I would like to write 0.5 P in here. 0.5 P in. So cancel this P in and V in. We will get 10 log 0.5. 10 log 0.5 is equal to minus 3. Then take this voltage equation. At this point, the output voltage is 70.7% of the input voltage. So by substituting this, instead of output voltage, we can write 0.707 V in. If we cancel V in and V in, we will get 20 log 0.707, that is also minus 3. So by calculating this voltage equation, we will get minus 3. By calculating this power equation, we will get minus 3. So these power and voltages are connected. This minus 3 is the minus 3 dB. This minus 3 dB is taken from this maximum point to calculate this half power point and calculate this bandwidth. So in this video, we have explained frequency response of RC coupled amplifier, low frequency range, high frequency range and mid frequency range, then the bandwidth, then the reason behind 3 dB calculations. So we need to connect this power and voltage to get this minus 3 dB. If you have taken this power equation and voltage equation, both will result in minus 3 dB. That is the reason behind this minus 3 dB value. That's all. Thank you.